Central government has promulgated an ordinance to demolish or abolish the UGC and to come up with a new setup called as Higher Education Council of India. Will this again degrade the education system in India?
It is a draft bill. Draft Higher Education Commission of India bill that is to abolish the UGC and bring in that place a Higher Education Commission. What is UGC? University Grant Commission. What is importance of that setup? The middle word G, grant. This grant is for two people. One is for an individual. Other one is for the institution. They give institutional grant and they also give an individual grant for fellowship and other things. Now, once you take away the grant, who will give grant in what type they will give? Will it be a loan or it will be a scholarship? Nobody can say. And when UGC goes away, when Higher Education Commission comes, it is not going to fix pay and all. So what type of a salary the teachers will get? What type of independence the teachers will get? What type of facilities the research scholars will get? All becomes a question. So there was an uproar entire India against the draft Higher Education Commission bill. In the 16th Lok Sabha ended, the draft bill did not become a bill. We hope that such a bill will not come in future. And there is another bill which was a pending bill that elapsed with the 16th Lok Sabha. What is that? National Medical Commission bill. What is the National Medical Commission bill is going to do? It is going to demolish the Medical Council of India. And when the Medical Council of India is demolished, the federal character goes away. The state's representation, all the state is having a representation in the Medical Council of India. But in the new setup, there will be only 6 representatives at a time. That means out of 29 states, you will have a representative only for 6 states at a time. That means 23 states and 7 union territories will go unrepresented at any point of time. So it is against the federal concept. And the bill says, there will be a NEET at the entrance and there will be a NEXT at the exit. For example, take in Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu Dr. MGR Medical University will conduct the first year exam, second year exam, third year exam, fourth year exam, and they will evaluate, they will give you mark sheet. And after passing all the 4 years, the candidate comes for the fifth year. Fifth year exam, Tamil Nadu Dr. MGR Medical University will not conduct, they cannot conduct the exam. Who will conduct an exam? Somebody like National Testing Agency. And if you pass that, you get a degree. If you don't pass, you don't get a degree. Take about the poor people, if they are admitted in a private college, after spending crores of rupees, the child doesn't become a doctor, doesn't get a degree. What will be the position of the family? Take about the people who are studying in a government college. They study all the 5 years, but still they cannot practice as a doctor. Two things you have to look at it. One, medical course is something linked with the health policy of a state government. The questions that you ask in a medical paper, go and ask any doctor who is an evaluator, who is a professor, you go and ask any doctor in any university, it is directly related to the health policy of the state government and the medical requirements of the people. India is such a vast country which has got different topography, landforms, different climatic conditions. So they have different food habits. And they, because of this, there are different types of diseases are there. Different types of insects are there. So many issues are there. So one question paper cannot address all the medical issues. So how can there be a common question paper in a medical profession? The next thing that you have to see is that someone is going to conduct an examination. How do you expect Dr. MGR Medical University, Tamil Nadu Dr. MGR Medical University, to give you a degree? I conduct an exam, I evaluate, and I give you a degree. But somebody conducts exam, you are asking me to give a degree. How can it be possible? So thereby again you say, there need not be an institution called university. If you say that there need not be an institution called university, you hand over the education and health to the market, then there won't be any research for the people, of the people, by the people. It will not for the development of this country, this society. So it will create a lot of social issues like this in the entire higher education sector, right from UGC, MCI and other areas. They are trying to demolish all the constitutional institutions, constitutional bodies that has come out because of the aspirations of the freedom fighters, that has come out because of the freedom fighters' dreams, the first generation leaders of this nation thought it should be in place. Now that legacy is being demolished and you are trying to replace totally a market concept that comes right from Niti Aayog. That is why we demand the planning commission should be brought back. And that should be a developmental agenda. And the developmental agenda must come from the people, from the participation of all states. Only such a kind of setup will try to save the higher education.